Yeah, Bowser's Mario, a little dragon.
I think you could safely describe Mario as a wizard.
But I mean, are you a wizard if it's specifically just getting magical?
Are you a wizard if you just have? Are we gonna crack that open again? The wizard discussion.
Yeah, I don't know if we.
Well, no, I think it's a matter of if you like. He's not a giant either because he eats a mushroom, you know.
Yeah.
And gets big.
Like he's just a regular fella, and then occasionally he's a big guy, and occasionally he shoots fire.
I'm not sure what kind of superpower I described to going from being short-ish to tall-ish. You know,
I'm actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about power-ups, I'm kind of surprised by the breadth of the power-ups that they used in the film, like the mini mushroom thing. Like, I didn't know that they'd be using that, or the ice flower as well. Tanuki suit was, they were definitely going to use that, obviously.
I just find it funny that Grace Randolph apparently complained about it, because she said it wasn't set up properly and properly explained.
It wasn't properly set up or explained that there's a Tanuki power-up in the Mario world.
I don't even... It's just funny.
The other one's made a lot of sense.
Oh, you want?
Well, because me and Rags watched it, it was like, what makes sense? Like, what exactly were you grabbing Mario onto in this world?
Yeah.
They go into the sewers and get sucked into a mystery mushroom world. Why does that happen?
That makes sense.
I understood that part.
As far as playing by its own rules goes, though, I mean, they did set up that the question mark boxes give you items that give you mysterious powers that often give you suits which you gain the attributes of the thing that you touched. You know, so I don't know. I thought they made it make sense within the context of itself.
I don't know why she would complain about something like that. It's Mario.
Now, how does the cat suit make sense if the Tanuki suit doesn't, you know?
That's the first thought I had. Is just like, what is her metric? Why is she picked on that? Like, of all things. Okay.
Was that meant to be like a piece of meaningful criticism of this film?
I don't know. I've already heard it repeated. I haven't actually like seen it in context.
That's pretty funny.
Also,
it's funny because we already had a movie in 1993 where they tried to like explain all the things about Mario. It's like they jump high. Okay, let's give them like space boots. Where do the dinosaurs come from? They're deep under the earth. And it was like super took itself too seriously at certain parts. Like, I'm glad that with this new one, they just like, yes, those are the video game elements, whatever, they're there.
Have you seen it yet, John?
I haven't, but I got nothing against it. I would like to see it.
I think you'll like it.
I think so too. It's doing the thing where adults will be like, huh, and it'll be an hour and a half, so it's not too bad, and children will love it.
Yeah, I figure kids will really dig it.
I figure that basically most people who like Mario will be like either okay with it or happy with it.
Yeah.
But I mean, as for being a film itself, it's pretty, it's like, it's fine. It's middling.
Fine.
You've seen a lot of movies before, but like, I don't think anybody's going to walk out of the theater angry. And they will be making more of these films, guys, because it's going to make about $360 million worldwide opening weekend.
I'll be waiting for that Zelda and Star Fox announcements. That's what I'm interested in.
You think they're going to do Star Fox?
Zelda.
I think they could be convinced by the Once teams that Star Steam. Fox isn't popular enough like as a gaming IP or whatever, but that there should be someone there to tell them, trust me, as a film, this thing will kick off.
Once they pick up a little bit of steam with these movies, quote unquote, pick up steam, they get a few down the road. I think people will be so ready for Star Fox at that point. You get the Zelda and the other stuff, you know. Done.
Well, so that's a real question. Are we actually going to be doing Super Smash Brothers at this point?
I think that's an inevitability.
That one's the no-brainer.
If they do like a Mortal Kombat style thing, tournament, and the winner of the fight gets the big magic star.
It would be that, like, they'd find some excuse to have them fight, but then they'd eventually work together. Like, it would be the blending of worlds. They'd work together to beat the big bad. The Master Hand. That's Master Hand. Because they're definitely going to make more Mario movies. There's no way that that's not... That's happening.
Oh, I will say as well, watching Charles Martinet play his in-universe father... I was like,
He played Jumpman in the little intro where they were doing the Mario Luigi voice, and he was there playing playing Donkey Kong on the little arcade machine, and he was
stuff
doing
like that. I was like, I don't hate you as much now.
All right, for not letting him play Mario, giving him stuff like that. That does help. I mean, that film is like loaded with references. Like, there's so many like little nods and throwbacks to different games. There's like Duck Hunt, like Kid Icarus. The fact the original cartridge, like the original arcade game. There was, of course, all of the musical cues and everything. That was like jam packed with references.